be here for FYP TV, giving you your instant post-match reaction as Crystal Palace lose 2-1 to Manchester City, despite a very spirited performance. Palace went into the game on the back of some very poor results, but that wasn't showing until the 30th minute when City scored the first goal. Defensive lap by Andros Townsend, giving the ball away just 5 yards from his own box, putting Martin Kelly under severe pressure. Kelly attempted to make the tackle and unfortunately the ball bounced around and goal scored by Yaya Toure. Palace had plenty of chances to clear, and once again it's that shambolic defending that we've become accustomed to as Palace fans. Second half, introduction of Connor Wickham, Palace went to a 4-4-2. And benefited from it. It looked much more threatening. It was Wickham, the man that came on with the goal. Great ball by Zaha again, and Wickham getting his second goal in two games. But unfortunately, Palace being Palace weren't able to hold on. City piled on the pressure in the last 10 minutes. And against the run of the play, unfortunately, got the second goal. A sloppy corner that wasn't caught and defended by Palace resulted in City taking the lead. A few points to note from the game. The actions of City players riled up many of the Palace fans. The Argentinian contingent of Otamendi, Zabaleta and Aguero was actually quite appalling how they behave as professional footballers. They look rather amateurish in their professionalism, and they riled up many Palace fans. Going forward, Palace looked a lot more threatening in the second half with the introduction of 4-4-2. And it took until the 30th minute for half the crowd to even know that Townsend was on the pitch, and that was when he gave the ball away. And hopefully we'll start seeing 4-4-2 coming in, with Connor Wickham being the man coming in and Townsend being the man missing out. I'd like to give a big shout out to Wayne Hennessy coming in, replacing Steve Mondonga. Wayne came under a lot of criticism last season, some rightly so, some wrongly so, but the big man hardly put the foot wrong. Apart from the second goal, potentially, and watch the replay. Two very good saves. The one of note from Aguero that actually set up the counter attack that gave Palace the equaliser. So, props to you, Wayne. And my man of the match, Johan Cabaye. That man was everywhere today. Another player that's come on a bit of criticism from some of the Palace fans on Twitter. Going forward, defending, putting himself about. There wasn't a better man on the pitch today than Johan Cabaye. I'm in Skippy reporting for FYP TV. If you agree or disagree, please comment, share, and follow FYP Fanzine on Twitter, Facebook, and on Instagram. Thank you.